What up, it's Brandon here and welcome back to another review. Today we're going to be reviewing the Micro MT Plus 2019 edition. Before I talk any more about it, I just want to let you know a bit more of my background in skating. First off, I'm definitely just an aggressive rollerblader. I've done a really little amount of big rail skating. It wasn't until like this year that I got on any wheel bigger than a 74 mil. These actually happened to be my first ever pair of free skates. And I actually got them for free. Micro sent them to me, so thanks Micro. I'm definitely a bit of a noob when it comes to the whole free skate scene. So just keep all that in mind as I review the skate. So to start off, I just want to talk about the things that I don't like about the skate. Now everything I'm going to mention here is very minor. It's really hard for me to find anything, if I'm honest. But one thing that was really annoying about it is every time I do the buckles up on these skates, especially the 45 degree one, it's actually really hard to get the buckle to go into the little holder it has after the buckle. They just don't naturally want to go there. You got to remember to hold it in as you tighten it. But once you remember to do that, they're totally fine. All the buckles seem really good quality as well, especially that 45 degree one. I love the ratchet thing to it. It really gets your foot in there. It's almost a little bit too good. It's really, really good quality. The other thing I don't like about it is just the fact that the laces go in the boot and the liner. I'm sure it's just optional. You're meant to do whatever you want, but when I'm given options like that, I just don't know what to do. Laces can go all the way to the top, which would be really good if you did want to get that really tight. But I don't want to do that just because it's going to be really annoying to take them off. So I've just skipped the top two eyelids. And now what's happening is the laces are kind of just in the way of that 45 degree strap. I'm glad there's options, but I'd rather there not be a liner option. That's just me though. And the only other things I don't like about it is just the cosmetic parts of it and how it looks. This is just all personal, it's just what I think, but I really don't like the graphics on the skate. It really brings the skate down if you ask me. In particular on the frame and the wheels, I noticed even Lino himself, he was spray painting the graphics off his black wheels when he was trying these skates out. They have drastically calmed down on the graphics on the skate compared to the last year's one. So I think they're on track, but honestly I think it would just look so much better if they just went for something a lot more simpler, not this like graffiti thing. That's just me though. And the other cosmetic thing I don't like is just the handle. I really don't understand what this texture is. It almost looks like a misprint. I don't know, it's weird. So like something's been ripped off. I'm not the biggest fan, but it works as a handle and that's all it's got to do, right? But yeah, that's pretty much everything I don't like about the skate. Let's talk about the things I do like. First off, just the hardware. Every bolt in the skate is very well made. They all just seem to go that little bit deeper than I'm used to with aggressive skates. It really, really makes me realize how bad the hardware on aggressive skates are. The whole hardware of the skate just feels so much better. Like it's gonna last. It feels top quality, I guess. Although I do wish I tightened it when I first jumped on them because both frames ended up moving so that they're both tilting in at different angles and I didn't even notice until I looked at them. I wasn't sure if that's how they came, but it's just the frame bolt got loose. So, I don't know. If you do get the skates, remember to tighten the bolts before you skate them. Like it says on the box, you should do that. Another thing I really like about it is the laces. They got this cool double lace thing happening that I really like. It makes them really strong. I don't think I'm going to rip them. They don't feel quite as strong as a hockey lace, but they seem good quality. And I really like the little Micro logo on the end. It looks really cool. I think that's more the style they should go with when they do the cosmetics for the skate. Just like little subtle things. Even the Micro logo on the frame looks cool, just the subtle one. But I don't know, once again, this is my opinion. The thing I like most about the skate though is just the whole round feel of the skate. It ties into how my frames were loose. I didn't even notice, that's how nice these skates feel compared to my aggressives anyway. I didn't notice that they were crooked, they still felt so smooth. Everything from the comfort to the control to the smoothness, it's all just so nice. The liner is a really good quality, you know. There's nothing wrong with it, it's totally fine. I don't see the need to upgrade it. The skates are also nice and light, which is good. But just like, the whole skating them is just so much fun. Every time I go from skating these to my aggressive, it just like, oh man, it makes me disappointed, you know, because these just feel so much more fun to roll around on. And I am skating flat and aluminum frames aggressive, and there's still just this huge difference in skating. I really can't find the point that makes these skates so much nicer to roll around than my aggressives. These skates are really making rollerblading fun for me again. It's really fun to just roll around. As soon as I put them on, man, it's just something about it. The wheels, the bearings, the frames are all really great. The wheels are nice and like soft and grippy, so it's a really smooth roll, but they're not too soft from the fact that they smash out. This all just feels really, really good quality and really smooth and fun. So just to summarize what I've talked so far, I think this is a great budget skate. Coming in at $130, I think. Now, obviously, I don't know too much about the pricing of free skates, but from what I've experienced so far, I definitely say it's worth that $130. It's a great quality product that's gonna last you, and I don't think it's gonna limit you anyway. You're gonna enjoy skating these. The only changes I would really make to the skate is cosmetic changes, and that's really a personal thing. It looks like they're heading towards a more subtle future as well, so I'm sure the next one's gonna be even cooler. But yeah, definitely say 100% recommend these skates to someone looking for their first pair of free skates like me. I mean, I am a beginner, so I'm not exactly an expert on what's a good free skate, but there's literally nothing I can find wrong with these, and I'm having a blast skating these. I sprung a whole nother side of rollerblading that I never even thought about, and it's just been fun, all around fun. I'm very impressed. Anyway, that's gonna do it for my review on the Micro MT Plus 2019. Huge thanks again to Micro for sending me them. I'm in no position to invest any money in anything but aggressive skating, so this is a really cool eye-opening thing for me, and I'm having so much fun, so thank you so much. Anyway, before we go though, I just want to let you know that this hat, as well as the whole row series, is actually back on the Laced shop right now for a limited time. So if you wanted to get it, now's the time. Check out the store. And you can also get 25% off the new Animal series with code 6MONTH. So check that out as well. But anyway, thanks so much for watching and just for everything in general, guys. Huge shout out to my patrons, Adam, Kevin, Deb, Dennis, Fabian, Flowey, Mark, Matt, Mike, and Tage. And I'll see everyone on Friday.